Good morning, listeners, and welcome to the Trade Talk podcast. Today, we need to start with the global cues as the Singapore Nifty is down more than 150 points. It is following to the global cues where Hang Seng is down more than 3%. US stocks slipped on Friday and US futures wavered amid challenges from the China Evergrande Group debt crisis and a Federal Reserve meeting this week that is expected to hint at moving toward tapering stimulus. While going through with our markets on Friday, the Nifty opened up with a gap and hit a fresh high at 17,792, but due to profit booking at higher levels, it shed all intraday gains and finally closed near to the day's lower level. Technically, on daily charts, the Nifty has formed a bearish candle that is broadly negative for the market. However, the medium-term texture of the market is still positive. For the day traders, 17,700 would be the immediate resistance level. Below the same, correction wave is likely to continue up to 17,450 or 17,300. On the other side, above 17,660 levels, uptrend texture will likely to continue up to 17,700 or 17,750 levels. Look for buying opportunities between 17,450 and 17,300 levels. In the past, the market has spent considerable time between the levels of 17,300 and 17,450 levels, and after that we saw vertical rally up to 17,800. So certainly 17,350 is going to act as major support for the market, and certainly there we should look for adding some long positions. Until the market is not crossing 17,800, traders need to be careful while adding long positions between 17,700 to 17,800 levels. In brief, in case if we see the market is bouncing back to the levels of 17,700, we should look for taking some contra bets by going short with a stop loss at 17,800 during the week. On the downside, 17,450, 350 is the area where we should look for adding some positions with a medium term view. But in case if we see the market is dropping to the levels of 17,300, then there we should look for taking long bet on index with a stop loss at 17,200 on the downside. For the Bank Nifty, yes, there was outperformance, and we need to keep a close watch on the Bank Nifty. We saw late day recovery on Friday in Bank Nifty, but again 37,000 is going to act as major support for it, and between 37,000 and 36,750, certainly we should look for taking some contra bet on the Bank Nifty. The focus should also be on auto companies because most of them close on the higher side on Friday. We like Bajaj Auto, Bharat Forge, as well as we are going to focus on Escorts as well as Eicher Motors. Metal sector should remain under some pressure till the global markets are going to remain weak or till the global markets are subdued. Especially the issue of Evergrande Group is going to impact on all these metal companies, and that's why we should be little bit away from metal companies for the time being. If there is a medium to long term view, certainly we should look for adding stocks like Tata Steel, Steel Authority, Hindalco, Nalco to our trading portfolio or positional portfolio. But for the time being, it is better to stay away from taking any short term bet on metal companies. For the IT companies, we are going to remain positive, but currently they are very close to their important resistance level. So buying is advisable if there is any correction. Our preferred picks are Tech Mahindra, Infosys and TCS. Finally, from the FMCG group, Hindustan Lever was around 2725, 2730 levels. 2700, 2650 is the area where we should look for adding even Hindustan Lever to our short-term positional portfolio. Friends, that's all from my side for the day. Thank you for listening in. Have a great day to all of you.